I will try in the next few minutes to explain what was my path to the IoT and also what was the path of one small startup prior to be acquired by Bosch. And after that, I will go in deep regarding the current IoT strategy of Bosch and the promise that all the Bosch product is intended to be connected up to 2020. In case you have any questions, just raise a hand, ask, and so on. It is not a problem for me to talk 40 minutes or 2 hours, but I really intend to have some kind of discussion. Okay, first one, as you know, Bosch is a German company, so I will refer one German newsletter, newsletter built that is referencing the summit in 2016. This newsletter is similar to the English Sun or other biggest one. So at that point of time, lots of, how to say, the Germans understand one new terms named Internet of Things. And in the prior 2 years, it was, how to say, the marketing term. The term itself exists from the last century, but in the last 2 years, almost everything connected to the stuff and to the product was named Internet of Things. First, a few facts regarding the Internet of Things. It is predicted and currently it is really growing the number of connected devices to the Internet. It is expected to have more than 20 billion single devices connected to the Internet to the 2020. Also, I just asked a question in my abstract. It's that currently there is no really the killer application. Everyone develops something, trying to implement some kind of connectivity, but no one currently have found the really the killer applications that is intended to be distributed everywhere. Okay, regarding the profit, this is just for Germany, and it is very near in 2020, more than 20 billions. But there are always, but currently almost every company trying to develop something that they named a platform. And really exist more than 450 IoT platforms, and such kind of platforms really competed for users. We're joking sometimes that every company just checking the platform and say there is no one that has the feature that I want, and after that the number of platform increases by one. Also, one of the interesting and pointing stuff is that there is no IoT business model. The IoT business models differs for every company, and it is really connected with the digital transformation of the company. Most of the companies know that they need to go to the internet, they need to be connected, but they don't know how to do it. Simple connectivity of the product doesn't really mean that you add a business value. You need to find the right business model in order to implement the Internet of Things. And also, currently, as most of you know, usually the startups are the innovators of the in the IT area. So lots of the startups are currently acquired by the big tech gigants in order to implement their IoT solutions. And lots of billions are on the market. But from my point of view, and I want also to thank to all of you, the developers are the new king makers. If you go to our booth, participate in our hackathon, you will see that you just grab some small pieces, for example Raspberry Pi, connected to the sensors, and you are really connected. And connectivity and the business model starts from the technical stuff. So it is really important to put the developers in the center of this new digital transformation, and it is not really the revolution, because this happened almost 20 years ago and continue, but it's a very good evolution in order to make everything connected. Okay, a few slides regarding how everything started. The first picture is from 1998. It is one of my first participation in the German Congress of Financial Institution, and this was probably my only one participation in the sales. At that meetings, I talk about distributed transaction, messaging, stuff like that, and the opposite side didn't really understand. And I decided after that just to participate in the technical conferences, because I really think that for me it is important, just the technology, not to try to do the job that is not my job. I always find over the years that the developers and the programmers in most cases are very bad sales, and they should not do the selling. The other pictures are from Java1 and embedded system conferences, also advertisement from the beginning of the century. And I started with Build, but in Bulgaria we have one paper named Computer World. And from September 2000, there is one article for the Bulgarian programmer that we are specialist in the Java-based stuff. As you can see, in 2000, almost every technology that is currently mentioned regarding the Internet of Things really exists. The protocols for connectivity, the gateway, the stuff. Also, at that this point of time, was just several months after splitting our company to two and creating SAP Labs Bulgaria. In 2000, it was, how to say, the time of the venture capitalists. Lots of the money was invented. I remember one of the pictures of the previous was from Java Enterprise Solutions Symposium in Paris. The whole Paris at that point of time was full with banners. We are the dot of .com. Maybe you remember this company? Currently the company is dead. But the things are changing. Also, at that point of time, there was no FTP download, almost no internet, so we sell in boxes. And our data sheet for embedded server that we still selling as a product look almost the same as the current one. Okay, but just to going now, what happens in this year? If we go to the prediction of IDC regarding the IoT platforms, we can see that in the next few years, up to 2 to 5 years, we expected IoT platform to go to the mainstream, to be the revenue model for the companies. Currently, lots of the companies invest in IoT, but really, very few of the company make a real profit from the IoT. I hope that our company will be one of the companies that will make profit in the next years. But there is always one good stuff. Currently, almost 20% of the company that started the digital transformation have something in place. Also, more than half of the companies plans to have some kind of IoT platforms in order to implement connectivity and digitalization. Also, more than 70% of the companies started some of the IoT project. But there is always, but what is really named as an IoT now? First, over the first year, prior marketing the terms IoT, in most cases it was named M2M platform. In M2M case, we, how to say, just connect some kind of machine, they talk each other, doing some kind of automation, and that's everything. But this is very, very custom solution. We also see the second part. If we have one simple smartphone application, one device, there is a lots of smart contracts, smart boilers, smart sensor that just implement this. But this is for one user, it is not really scalable. Probably one of the good one, but not the best, is the gateway solution. There is a lots of home automation systems, for example, that consist of one gateway, several devices that implement the home automation scenarios. For example, scenarios like security, control of the home, and so on. But as I already mentioned, there is a lack of horizontal platform. If you want to connect 100 millions of devices, it is impossible to have simple use cases. You need to provide infrastructure as a service, cloud storage and so on. You need to provide the platform itself as a service. And also, you need to provide a valuable service for a particular market. One of the lessons learned during my more than 20 years development is that you cannot sell the technical solutions to the end customer. It is impossible. You can sell a technical solution only to the technical companies. Okay, I want to show some examples from the Bosch in the area what is the connectivity today. Maybe some of you have this very good washing machine. There is a very simple sensor that just based on the infrared, it identify what is the exact waste. And after that, the washing machine adopt based on the waste. The algorithm is similar to the pattern recognition. You just check the patterns against lots of patterns, and this is very interesting application of artificial intelligence, named for the single user. And this product is on the market. For some of our industrial customer, for example, Osram, probably all of you know this light manufacturer, we implemented a ticketing system. And the funny stuff is that some of the machines inside their factory are more than 100 years old. And there is a possibility to be connected. How? You can just put a very simple sensor, measure the spin, do some kind of preventive diagnostic and so on. After that, you can connect this stuff directly to the backend system and even directly invite the personnel to check the stuff if something goes wrong. Probably one of the most popular, even available in Bulgaria, solution is smart home. There is a lots of smart home systems selling on the market. And this is very simple. You just have some kind of gateway, connecting devices, receiving information, smart home application and so on. Our solutions currently have more than 1 million implementation. And because of the number of devices, even we have more than 100 different devices in one project. It is important that most of our customers understand that no one can do IoT alone. You need to form a partnership, you need to find a real way how to implement the scenarios for the end users. I think that the time that IoT was just technical are already over. IoT is on the market and you need to make money in order to be successful. The next example was done in Bulgaria, and it is for the oysters farm in Tanzania. Some of the colleagues traveled to Australia at that point of time. It was winter and they really liked the beach at that point of time. But just going to the solution. From a technical point of view, sorry. From a technical point of view, what is the exactly the problem with the oysters? If we have problems in the water, I mean more salt or particle, after going oysters outside of the water, you cannot eat it. And currently, mainly the prediction is based on the weather forecast. But if you add sensors inside the water itself, you can predict based on the analytics where exactly to harvest the oysters. And for a very small period of time, these solutions give us a profit. We have a lot of, how to say, technical problem. If you put something in the water with the solar panels, it is almost impossible from the south to collect the energy, so we need to implement some kind of solutions that just every few hours boot up, collecting data from the sensor, connecting to the backend system, and after that sleep. But this is just the technical solution that can be solved. The important is not the technical solution itself, but the value that gives to the Australian farmers. I will not go in deep in more of the other examples, but this is, for example, connected filters. It is the typical example of servicing. There is a gateway inside, for example, the trucks or machines that have a sensor to check what exactly is the filters. There is a company that offers the service to changing the filters. And also you have a backend system that collects all the stuff. And all these solutions was developed in Sofia, Bulgaria. I'm proud to say that currently we participate from Sofia in probably the biggest one solution in the area of connected cars. Currently, more than 5 million cars are connected, and every month more than 2,000 cars are implemented at the edit of the project. Every week to the car is distributed different kind of data, navigation, software update, and so on. I already mentioned that there is a different way of digital transformation. Every company needs to find his own DNA and to find his way to the digital transformation. And for a few weeks, we received for the second time the Digital Transformer Award in the year, and our company is prepared in order to do the digital transformation of the company, starting from the business models and implementing the IoT solutions. Some facts, currently we connect more than 8 million products, from them 4 million, I already mentioned, is the car. More than 100 devices in one customer project. And also I want to say that we are cloud agnostic. Currently we implemented our solution not only for the Bosch private clouds, but also for the Amazon, Azure, SAP Leonardo, Huawei, and so on. Next slide are regarding our strategy and our way, how we exactly think that Internet of Things will be implemented, and what is the current state. First, I already mentioned lots of examples regarding the enablement of the IoT. This is just connecting something to the Internet. Currently, in 2016, 50, half of the Bosch product are already connected. We adding 10% in 2017. Our company goal is to have 100% connected product from everything that can be connected to the developed in Bosch to have a possibility to be connected. Also, we are proud that currently in our private cloud, the Bosch IoT cloud, the solutions from 70 in 2016 are more than doubles. And this is the real solution for particular manufacturer. And the number of IP-enabled products, we sell another 10 million in this year, and we will continue to increase the amount of the product in the next. What is exactly the strategy of the Bosch? It is usually named the triple S. Bosch is the biggest producer of micromechanical sensors. In most cases, your phone contains sensors from Bosch in the area accelerometer, GPS sensor, proximity sensor, for example, iPhone, Apple Watch, lots of Android phones rely on that. Bosch sensors are also in every car, in almost everywhere. On top of this sensor cloud, you need to have a middleware that extracts the data from the sensors and deals with the actuators. We provide such kind of middleware, and our name for this middleware is the Bosch IoT Suite. On top of that, lots of the companies, not only Bosch one, develop the custom solutions for particular market. For example, for connected vehicles, connected market industry, and so on. And currently, the Bosch is the only company that can cover the triple S. Lots of the companies go from opposite direction. I mean the software companies like Microsoft and Google. They have only the upper part without such kind of cost to be close to the hardware. And this is the opportunity that Bosch intend to use in the next years. What exactly, from a development point of view, is this infrastructure as a service, cloud as a service, and so on? First, if we go to the IoT cloud, it's the similar in the other cloud, you need to have a basic services for storage, network, security. On top of that, you need to have really IoT services in the area of analytics, digital twins, device management, and so on. And based on this basic infrastructure, I mean both infrastructure as a service and platform as a service, it is possible to develop the end solution for the connected mobility, connected energy, home building, and so on. I will not go in deep because I will repeat again some of the solutions, but what I want to say is that all this stuff is already on the market. There are existing products. You can even go to the supermarket and buy some of them. Okay, enabled. Usually the enabled is easy. You just have something connected to the internet, but in order to provide it, this should not be the one-time solution. So you need to digitalize the existing ecosystem. And the people here, the developers, are really the important part of this digitalization. If you have, for example, one solution that is typical gateway or M2M, usually you need to have, 50 developers or 100 developers, and they can support such kind of solution. But if you have a platform, you need to have 1,000 DevOps that just dealing with the partners. And this really doesn't mean that this is the one company. Currently, the Bosch employs 65,000 software engineers. 4,000 of them are just IoT developers. But our intention is based on the statistic that we need at least 10,000 developers in order to have one platform to be successful. As I already mentioned, currently there is 450 platforms. Who knows who will win? But I hope one of the platforms that will still exist will be the Bosch one. And I want to mention one example that we do with probably one of the biggest insurer in the world. This is the Red Digital, Munich Re. They exist for more than 100 years. For example, they even pay insurance of the San Francisco earthquake in 2006, also Hurricane Katrina and so on. And in order to develop their insurance model, they really need lots of the IoT in order to predict the risk. Typical examples, some of them are already mentioned in the news, is you have a black box inside your car, it collects the data from you, and based on that, you receive an insurance that is small. Similar can be the industry. You have a very expensive machine, you connect some sensors, data is going directly to the insurer, so based on the predictive maintenance and diagnostic, the insurer reduce the money that you need to pay to. It is very difficult in such a complex situation to find the exact business model and find a way how the IoT will be applied. But this is ongoing and this is the real project. At the end, there is already a box selling on the market. There is already automotive insurance that is based on the driver behavior and so on. And all of this is based on the lots of the data. I want to mention that data itself is not a value. The algorithms and the work that you do is the value that is added to the data. If you extract something meaningful, this is the important stuff. And maybe you can see this picture that over the year, software eating the world. Almost everything, the like books, notes, fax machine, and so now is just a computer. So for the big company like Bosch, they what is the solution? Probably to become a software company. Okay, I didn't start it with the introduction in the beginning, and I want to say some words for me. As many of you, in the 80s, I started with private computer, but they are IBM PC and Apple II compatible. The funny stuff is that the first language that I started was Pascal. After that, switching to Basic, C++, Java, and so on. From a perspective regarding the my work, the first technology, even in 99, that I mentioned was the OSGI, and I really participated for creating of the open technology almost from the beginning. Also, I already mentioned that I started with the startup, and from 98, my position is research and development manager. So, telling to the HR, I don't have any development in the last 20 years. Regarding the development, what is important after that? The technologies are changing over the years, and I want to cite one quote of the Antoine Saint-Exupéry. If you want to build a ship, don't teach the sailor to drum the wood or to divide the work. Teach them to learn regarding the endless sea. If you apply this to the developer, the technologies are changing over the years. You know one cool technology, after that is changed with the others and so on. But always you need to see the big picture. You need to dream regarding the solution, what exactly is the application of the technology and so on. Also, I'm always trying how to say, to be more leader than the manager. In most cases, for me, what is the difference? Manager usually say you need to do something. Leader do the hard work and the whole team develop the stuff together with his leader. Regarding the Bosch Software Innovation, I want to say that we are incubation center of Bosch. We trying the new technologies, the stuff, the culture, the agility. And our focus, especially in Sofia, is related only to the software regarding the Internet of Things. And how to say, all of our colleagues are intended to go to the extra mile to help to the customer in order to implement the solutions. Probably this is the, how to say, the pictures. In order to do the digital transformation, you should not block the existing business of the company. You should go in deep to define the business model together and after that to implement a meaningful solution together with the customer. And reference to Antoine Saint-Exupéry, you need to dream regarding the solutions, not regarding the technology, how cool is Spring Boot, OSGI, Java, or some legacy technology. At the end, the customer will see the end application that is work. Also, one important stuff regarding the Bosch and the strategy is open source. Over the years, we found that open source is a very good way for collaboration. And participating in an open source project gives to our developer the way to think open and to receive help from additional companies. Bosch started in 2004 regarding the open source. Regarding me, I'm committed in Eclipse from 2007. Also important regarding the open source is that PowerPoint, like I currently do, is not the important stuff. Usually you should open the development environment, go over the example, but currently I'm presenting the keynote. Okay, I see some left. Probably we can answer after that the question. What are the main projects that is based at our solutions currently? The first one is, all of them are part of the Eclipse IoT, and you can go and check it. They are based on the concrete use cases in the area of IoT. For example, the digital deals with the digital twins. If you have something in the internet, it is the exact representation of the concrete device. For example, if you have lamp, you have a microservice in the internet, and you can put a brightness on, off, and this immediately affect the concrete device. Also, you need to have a solution to deliver the software updates to the devices. This is the Hawkbit. When we developed one of our first solutions, probably more than 10 years ago, it was with Mile, and one of the reasons that they developed the connectivity was lots of their price is servicing. And in order to do the servicing, usually they need to set the team twice. First to detect the problem, and if there is need to be changed something hardware, to send to the second time. If we have a connectivity and a software update, lots of the problems are fixable using the remote control. And probably you don't know how many software is in your fridge or in your car, but currently, for example, in the car it's gigabytes. And this software needs really to update. As you know, every software has a box. Regarding the Eclipse Homo, this is the messaging protocol for connecting devices to the cloud. Leshan is one popular machine-to-machine protocol. And at the end, we need to have some kind of basic modeling that is provided to the Vorto that just define the models. And after that, you can use these models in order to implement different kind of devices. We'll not go in deep. But when we selling the products, it is, how to say, almost 90% based on this open source. And we selling the service and some specific stuff that are related to the security, quality, and so on. I want to stress the two parts that are developed in Sofia. This is the gateway software and the remote manager here. Do we have other opinion? Silence. Okay. Few words regarding the Internet of Things and the experience. This is the very good picture that in order to do the open source and open platform, you need to have everything open, starting from the the code, data, and so on. If you keep something secret, you can say this is proprietary, but in most cases, you cannot follow the technologies trying to do stuff by your own. The next important thing is that you need to develop the platform for the business, not individual product. And offering some meaningful stuff to the business is the real help to the business itself. And the business will buy your solution, not the other developer that you implement some cool technology that just exists from few months and will die after the few months again. Also, importance is agility, co-creation, not to have hierarchies like in the past. Working in the team is very important. Software is made by teams, not by individuals. And I want to stress to that one, the partnership. Currently, we work with lots of the companies, not only the software ones, with lots of developers collaborating with them. When we have a project, usually we contact different companies in Bulgaria, also if they have a concrete skill set in order to have the project. The important is to have a partners, to have an ecosystems. I don't intend all of you just after my presentation to apply for Bosch. I intend to think about the platform, probably to use the software, to think also and talk each other, to exchange the experience and so on. And this is very important. This slide is mainly what is exactly is developed in Sofia. We starting in Knowledge Alliance from 99, developing the gateway software and remote solutions. And currently it connects millions of devices. Again, one award for the second years we receive best platform for device management for the product that is developed in Sofia. I already mentioned in my opening keynote that we have a brand new office in Sofia, and from my point of view, the space is the body language of organization. You spend one third or more of your time in the office, so you need to have a space when you can be creative and to implement the different kind of IoT solutions. We are organizing a hackathon. I think the hour will be later, and organizing the hackathons is the one way in order to help the people to touch the technology, to touch the Bosch IoT suite, and find a way how exactly this Internet of Things can be applied. Regarding the Bosch IoT suite, I already mentioned that we are very open. And it is possible to do a self-service subscription. It is available in the Bosch IoT Suite website. We have currently running instances in China with Huawei, in Asia, Sub Leonardo, also in the Amazon. You can go directly to the Amazon web marketplace and subscribe. We offer the free plans for developer, so you can just go there, subscribe, receive the documentation, and start doing something. If you are interested in the open source, just participate in our open source project. You are invited. And also, if you want to be hired, even on open source, just ask us. We pay people to work on the open source project. Okay, what is our slogan now? We connect everything. You can go to our website, explore our service, and currently I'm putting one question mark, and probably we will ask you to think what is really the Internet of Everything, what we can expect after 10 years. Currently this is the 10th Java2Days. What will be presented after 10 years? Artificial intelligence, flying cars, connected solutions, and so on. It is, the boundaries are just in your mind. And currently, lots of the stuff that are just a dream prior 20 years when I started is currently a reality. And currently it is 39:45 seconds. I have a few more minutes if you want for questions. Thank you very much. Any questions?
Hello, thank you for your talk. So my question was like more about do you plan on doing things about waste management and utility management, or it's just about device connectivity oriented, like for your products and stuff? Or?
No,
my question was about if you're planning on doing things about waste management and utility management, you know, in the IT sector.
Just to mention that as a company we're developing mainly the middleware. On top of this middleware, it can be implemented in the different areas. So probably if you want to implement the connectivity solutions in that area, it is more for our partners and developer companies, not for you, not for us. So probably there can be such kind of solution, but this solution is offered by the customer, not by us.
Any other questions?
Thanks. I suppose if you want to connect everything, then your middleware platform should be able to support multiple protocols, for example, like Zigbee. How is that currently? What's the amount of protocols you're supporting?
The concrete protocol. Currently, I think we supported more than, 26 protocols. And there are, for example, wireless protocols like Zigbee, Z-Wave that are very popular. The wired protocols like Homebus, KNX, EHS, and so on. Also, the different kind of protocols that are connected to the Internet of Things. For example, MQTT, lightweight, M2M, open device management, and so on. You can go to our website and check the complete list of the protocols, but from my point of view, the protocols itself is not so important. I mean, when you develop, for example, the digital twins, you deal with the model of the device. And after that, you try to implement some kind of proxy or the driver that implements this protocol on, for the complete connectivity of the device. So you really deal with the abstraction. And you going to the Java style, you just instantiate the Java object named, for example, switch. And after that, you invoke the method on or off. And all the stuff is hidden by the middleware. You are specialists in that area to develop the lots of the drivers, lots of the connectivity, and after that to give to the end customer just a clear API and interfaces. Hope this answered to your question.
Thank you.
Yeah. Anybody else?
I was surprised not to hear you mention security at all. So if you're going to be the software that is connecting all the devices and they're talking to one another, I'd be interested in hearing how you encourage people to have appropriate security and to treat data confidentially.
Yeah, sometimes Internet of Things is named Internet of Unsecure Things. Probably you mentioned that. There is even the website that you can browse and go directly connecting to the cameras or the stuff using the normal security credential. One of the important pieces of our IoT suite is the set of security services based on the public key infrastructure. But there is always one, but if you want, for example, to use the wireless devices, for example, Zigbee and Z-Wave, if you put a security layer on top, usually one Zigbee and Z-Wave sensor can work 3 to 5 years with one battery. If you put security, it is just 1 month. So sometimes you need, to develop the proper model, which part of your solution should be secure or not. There is a possibility to secure everything, but if you secure everything, nobody will use your solution.
Anybody else?
So thank you very much. I'm on our booth on the fifth floor. You can go there and you can ask directly question at any time. Thank you for listening and not going to lunch.